Let me begin this little talk by expressing to you my personal greetings and good wishes as editor of the Model Engineer. My readers are a worldwide community united by a common interest in the practice of the mechanical arts and by the love of good craftsmanship for its own sake. They are further united by a remarkable spirit of good fellowship and mutual helpfulness which takes no account of differences in wealth or social position, but rejoices in good work well done. In my opinion, model engineers are the salt of the earth. Model engineering has many aspects. It is a fascinating and health-giving hobby. It is a valuable aid to invention. It plays an important part in education, and it facilitates many branches of scientific experiment and research. As a hobby, it offers you endless possibilities of pleasant and instructive recreation. When you close the door of your home workshop, you leave all your daily cares and problems behind you. You become absorbed in the model you are building, and you experience all the joy of the creative artist. You see growing before your eyes the miniature reproduction of the locomotive, or the ship, or the aeroplane you admire so much. Your model absorbs something of the loving care you devote to its construction, and when it is finished, it radiates this affection in the pleasure it gives to you yourself and to your family and friends. I know a doctor who spent 13 years in building a beautiful model of a locomotive. Someone said to him, "Don't you think, doctor, you could have devoted 13 years of your spare time to some better object?" His reply was very illuminating. He said, "I have had 13 years of pleasure in building my model. It has given me many hours of relief from the anxieties of my professional work and has enabled me to face my daily duties both mentally and physically refreshed. Moreover, I have built a model which will have considerable historic value to future generations as a record of a very famous engine." This puts the case for the hobby value of model engineering in a nutshell. Engineers themselves, artists, musicians, lawyers, bank officials, and people of every kind of business interest have expressed their views to me in a very similar strain. They all agree that model making is the most absorbing and fascinating hobby they could possibly pursue. It has one very exceptional virtue. It suits every pocket. Most interesting and attractive models can be built with the simplest of tools and materials, on the corner of the dining room table, given patience and ingenuity. Numbers of models of this kind can be seen at the annual exhibition organized by the model engineer. At the other extreme, those who can indulge their fancies for elaborate equipment or ambitious model building can rejoice in the possession of the metal turning lathes and machinery of a real engineering workshop. There is another side to the practice of model engineering. The problems of design and construction which arise in the building of an engineering model are in many instances precisely similar to those involved in building the full-sized engine or machine. For this reason, models are frequently built in engineering works as a preliminary step towards perfecting the design of the full-sized product. The famous engineers of 100 years ago, William Murdoch, James Watt, and George Stephenson, founded their epoch-making inventions upon experiments with models. And even today, in deciding the details of steamship and aeroplane design, models play a very important part. The achievements of model engineers in their home workshops are remarkable. Some of them build miniature steam locomotives which will haul a dozen or more live passengers on a garden railway. Some build baby hydroplanes which will travel on the water at 40 miles an hour. Others make clocks or telescopes, or build engines and dynamos to light their homes by electricity. Still again, some build models of old-time ships or engines which suitably preserve the memory of the engineering wonders of the past. If I may interpose a word of advice in regard to your own model-making efforts, it is this: be exact. Spare no trouble to obtain accurate plans and information from which to build. Spare no trouble in your building to be accurate in your materials and your measurements. A model which is worth building at all is worth building well. I know of no hobby which more readily or more agreeably promotes mutual friendship among its followers. A common interest in any branch of model engineering is an immediate passport to a friendly exchange of experience and knowledge. Since I founded the first model engineering society in this country in 1898, the club movement has spread all over the world. There are now over 100 clubs and societies at home and abroad, providing happy meeting grounds for those interested in model making in its various branches. Neither race nor language forms any bar to the intercourse of model engineers. The love of fine craftsmanship and creative effort is universal. My journal, The Model Engineer, is the central exchange for the radiation of knowledge among model engineers in all parts of the world. As its founder and editor, may I repeat my very cordial greetings to everyone who is listening to my voice. I shall be pleased to be of service to you in any possible way through the columns of my paper. And I wish you one and all many happy and profitable hours in your workshops and with your models.